My name is Amina. I've been working with Mutant Demont since Swiss since 2007. I worked in many projects. The main one was I was a project coordinator for the first community mental health center for child and adolescent. And now I'm working as a project coordinator for the child and detention project. Sadly, that when the child is put in prison, his childhood ends because he is forced into adulthood. He is forced. He is beaten. He is taken out of his safe environment from home. Interrogation is very, very difficult. So when he leaves, before he, yes, he feels like a hero. The community treats him as a hero, but at the end of the day, he can be have bedwetting or very anxious, start smoking because he was exposed to things at very early age. Yeah, it's like you are forcing him to adulthood. We chose, now we are working in the southern part, we chose Al Aroub refugee camp and Beit Umar village because they are two hot spots. They are located along Road 60 that is used by settlers. And military, of course, use this road to protect the settlers. And of course, it's used by Palestinians too. And so many clashes take place in that in the two hot spots. In addition to the military control on the entrances of both location, which makes it very a target for clashes and encounter points, and thus many arrests. Al Aroub camp, first of all, it's a very a small place, condensed. Many people are living there, almost probably 10,000 people in a very small place. The economic situation is very bad. No work at the very limited work at the camp. The entrances are controlled by military all the time. And there are lots of incursion. Whenever anything happens, you have night raids, you have incursion. They are allowed inside, which makes it very stressful for the people living in the camp. The military is targeting more boys and men and male, but that doesn't mean that this conflict or the detention is not affecting the girls. Other than having two detained children, girls, we have daughters of detained prisoners, sisters that are affected by this experience. We started with the mothers because we really thought that they need help because they are their houses are raided continuously, their children are taken, and they feel helpless because they cannot protect their children. Many women feel that there is nothing that they can do. And thus we give them activities to ventilate, to talk, and to have the space to express their emotions and feelings. We know that the situation is very bad from the moment of arrest until when the child is released. It's a very difficult experience for the child and his family.